The Defense Department says in a report, Chinese fishing vessels do more than just fish in the West Philippine Sea. The Chinese vessels are part of China's strategy to control the resource-rich waters and deny Filipinos access to their exclusive economic zone, or EEZ. The report says, quote, apparently, China has been utilizing fishing vessels to discreetly conduct surveillance, search and rescue operations, as well as provide possible assistance to Chinese law enforcement agencies. International reports have long stated that China uses fishing crews on board trawlers as maritime militia to push its territorial claims without using military assets and avoid overt warfare. It has been 3 months since a Chinese trawler rammed, sank, and abandoned Filipino fishing boat Jemver and its 22 fishermen in the open seas in the dead of night. The fishermen said the trawler had a metal body and powerful lights. Heinous crime convicts previously released on Good Conduct Time Allowance, or GCTA, have until Thursday, September 19, to surrender to authorities or be hunted by a police force with a track record of brutality. Bureau of Corrections or BUCOR spokesman Eduardo Del Rosario says, of the 1,914 who were released, only 964 have surrendered. The BUCOR and the police will hunt down these convicts despite the absence of a court order for the rearrest. President Rodrigo Duterte himself ordered the rearrest on September 4. Police Chief General Oscar Albayalde earlier said, if convicts resist arrest, they will be shot. Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara says the Justice Department is moving to sanitize the list ahead of the manhunt. Two men in BUCOR's list are already dead. The Department of Health, or DOH, declares a polio epidemic Thursday, September 19, after it records a case of the disease in Lanao del Sur. The health department found the disease in a 3-year-old girl who is now apparently well, but with residual paralysis. Health Secretary Francisco Duque III says the DOH declared an epidemic or outbreak after they found one positive case of the disease in Lanao del Sur, and after environmental samples from Manila and Davao tested positive for polio virus. Duque notes this is, quote, considered an epidemic in a polio-free country. The Philippines was declared polio-free since October 2000, with the last case of polio virus reported in 1993. A plebe at the Philippine Military Academy, or PMA, died Wednesday, September 18, due to internal bleeding. The PMA said the initial findings for the cause of death of Cadet 4th Class Darwin Dormitorio is cardiac arrest secondary to internal hemorrhage. Dormitorio earlier complained of stomach pain and was vomiting. The 20-year-old plebe from Cagayan de Oro City was found unconscious inside his room Wednesday morning. PMA graduate Senator Ping Lacson says the incident points to the persistence of hazing in the academy despite a stronger anti-hazing law. He says, quote, hazing is as old a practice as far as we can remember. Many upper-class cadets in the past were either dismissed, some had served time inside a military stockade, even charged before a court-martial, and lost their opportunities in life. The United States Justice Department files a lawsuit against former Central Intelligence Agency employee and National Security Agency contractor Edward Snowden. The civil lawsuit accuses him of violating non-disclosure agreements he signed with the CIA and NSA. Snowden says on Twitter, his book Permanent Record is the book the government doesn't want you to read. Snowden leaked information in 2013 about the U.S. government's mass surveillance program after the 9/11 attack. Charges under the Espionage Act are also filed against him. Thank you.